Hello and welcome to Kismet Rising. So today I'm coming to you with another energy update. So in the last two videos, I talked about the energy from September of 2019 till about November 2019. And then last week I uploaded a video in which I talked specifically about the Pisces full moon that we had and that energy around that, which would have been quite teary, quite emotional, feeling quite unsettled, not feeling grounded enough, feeling quite, quite on edge. Crying at the drop of a hat and just feeling quite uneasy in oneself. So this full moon is now behind us and we can look forward to a different kind of energy. We can look forward to some of the productive energy, which I mentioned we would be experiencing in the earlier forecast, which I did, which talks about the energy from September till November. And you know, we're basically picking up with that energy again. And yes, there are other factors at play, but it's not factors that are going to drop you down. They are more the kind of challenges that you will face now are basically going to be those kind of challenges that will help you to move ahead and to improve, on what you're doing, whether it's your strategy or whether it's your modus operandi. Basically, it's going to help you to improve that. It's going to show you where your downfalls are, and it's going to suggest to you ways in which you can improve what you've been doing already, or where you're headed to. So if you come across those kind of challenges, then welcome them and look at what you can learn from it. And it's rather not waste that energy fighting it or feeling disappointed or having an emotional reaction to it, but rather take a step back and see, what is this actually trying to tell me? And that is the kind of energy we're going to be working with between now and between the middle to the end of October. The other thing that's happening right now is that we have quite a lucky energy in that we can actually manifest most of what we desire. And the reason for that is because we have a lot of energy that's supporting us right now. We have a lot of basic support from the universe. It feels like things are moving ahead and there isn't a resistance from anything. And I'm not talking about astrology here. I'm not an astrologist. So this is just energy that I pick up from the universe and how we're being impacted by it. So a lot of things will move ahead right now and will make progress. So things that have been stuck will move ahead, and where you feel like you haven't been able to make progress, you'll be able to start finding that you're making great progress and that things are moving ahead finally, especially with regard to ventures. Like if you bought a new business, or you've started something new and it hasn't really taken off, or you've been wondering why there's a slump in your current business, or you've been trying to study and you haven't been making great progress, well, now is the time in which things are suddenly going to go forward with a certain kind of momentum that's behind you, almost pushing you. And as you go ahead, you're going to find that it's been easier to do what you've been doing or do what you want to do than it's been in the last few months, from, say, about the end of March or so. All right, so it's a completely different energy that we're working with, and it's not going to be reminiscent of what we've been doing in May or June or March. It's just going to be a whole new brand new energy that we can work with. And from a productive career point of view, it's an extremely good energy. Now, in terms of love, what's actually happening? Well, right now, one could say that we're sowing the seeds of what we will reap in around November or December or early next year, like up to about February for those who are always late on it. So what am I talking about? Well, you know, there are love interests that are brewing right now, or there are issues within a relationship that need to be dealt with right now so that you can reap the benefits of it later. And these issues are not necessarily negative things. You know, these are things that, you know, you can be looking at and to try to see how you can improve your relationship. You know, perhaps you need to spend more time with each other, and you're going to be finding ways in which you're going to see how you can spend that time with each other. If you are single and you are actually you don't have anyone at all, you're not interested in anyone at all, what does it mean for you? Well, in terms of this love energy, I feel like this time is going to be so productive for you, and you're going to be so satisfied in terms of your own being that you're not going to see it. You're going to be blindsided by a new love interest that's going to come into your life later on in the year, and then you have the choice of whether to take it or whether to actually move past it, because at that point you'll be so absorbed, and you would have delved so deeply into what you've been busy with that you actually won't really notice this person, or you won't really pay such a lot of emphasis on love at that point. So I see that happening around November, December. So in terms of love, like, there's a kind of high point around the end of November, December, the first week of December or so. And then there is, but right now the seeds for that are being planted. So we're talking about from about the 16th of September till about the 5th of October. Right now the seeds for that are being planted. And how are those seeds planted? Well, it's basically in terms of the energy that you're putting forth. It's basically setting the trajectory for you. And also what it's doing is that it's kind of setting an intention, so to say. And it can also be basically reviewing some things in terms of your love life, or there could be some red flags or alarm bells that go off, which kind of come to you right now, but they're not so strong, and then you kind of review it later on so that you have something new to work with, or an improved situation to work with come November and December. So that is your energy forecast for the weeks ahead. I would say that for the next 3 weeks, you're going to be doing fairly well. For some of you, you're going to be riding the storm as opposed to having the storm ride you. And for others of you, you're going to be basically focusing, putting your intentions out there, manifesting. It's a great time for visualization, setting your intentions and manifesting, whether it be in terms of work, or career, or money-related matters. Well, less so in terms of money-related matters, I would say. It's more in terms of work and productivity, and also in terms of love, okay? So I want to say also it might be a time where family becomes takes a new significance in your life. So the next few months, you might be looking at family in a different way than you've been before. So if you've been taking a step back from your family, you've been too involved in your own affairs, you might find that family comes back into the spotlight and you're paying more attention to loved ones. And if for those of you who have been quite involved with your family, you might actually be taking a step away and just being concentrated on what is important to you as an individual. So watch out for that. That's going to be quite interesting how it unfolds. And I think that it's going to be a wonderful few months ahead. So I'm wishing you all a lovely few weeks ahead, and much success to all of you, and much love and blessings abound from Kismet Rising.